thought she was having dinner with us.
Yeah, well, now she's not yet.
Typical. Charity always begins at home with you, Peter Barlow.
Oh, I'll just say three words to that, Rachid. Pop it all back.
And what's that supposed to mean?
What basis? Are you living with my dad on it? Because you're not his mother-in-law anymore, are you? I don't even do my family properly.
And since when is this any of your business?
No, really, there's no need for this. It's Christmas.
Oh. Yes, it's Christmas. It's a time you should be spending with your family. But then again, Dad, I'm all you've really got now, aren't I? Because if things would have been handled properly, we'd be having a proper Barlow Christmas, wouldn't we? Me? And you? Susan?
Yeah, well,
and Adam?
Don't need reminding of that.
If Deirdre wouldn't have gone shouting her big mouth off about how unfair we were being to poor old Mike Baldwin, because, oh yes, because there's a bloke who needs your sympathy. How different all this would have looked.
What are you dragging all this up again for?
Because I don't want you thinking, Deirdre, you can just sweep this under the carpet. We don't even get to see Adam at Christmas because Baldwin's whisked him off.
And that's all down to me, is it?
Yes, actually.
This is neither the time nor the place.
Oh, Dad, no. I mean, I don't expect you to say anything because you're just pitifully grateful that Deirdre's gracious enough to stay living with you.
Well, you're a fine one to talk. What about you and Shelley?
It's nothing to do with Shelley.
Oh, isn't it? Oh, well, no, I suppose it is a bit difficult to see what's going on under your own nose when you're up on your high horse. But I think it's pretty obvious to everyone else what she sees in you.
Yeah, you know,
she
no,
didn't
Deirdre.
Look at you twice until you got the bookie. She didn't want to know you till then. She's right. And now he's have to buy another rover. So you come and cheated. You
got some flaming nerve, Deirdre. Why my dad ever had you back after the way that you humiliated him, I will never know.
All right, that's enough.
Come on, running off with some toy boy waiting you met on your holidays and then some flaming con man that lands up in prison.
For heaven's sake, everybody's listening.
He started this! Didn't you? And then when you've had your regret to put it back to my dad, you won't marry him, will you? Oh no, because you've just given yourself that little bit of space for the next time, when that next slime ball comes along, and you can look him in his eyes, and you can look at him and you can say, oh no,